Today I want to make a Civil3d surface. This is the data that we are going to use. So as you can see, we have the point number. So we also have the eastings, northings. This is the point elevation, and this is the description of the points. This data is saved in CSV, comma delimited. So this is the format. So if you don't save in that, if you save in Excel workbook, it's not going to be available for the AutoCAD to map those points. So as you can see, it is in CSV, comma separated values. So this is the Excel, this is the data, then I'm going to replace it. And how do you import that data to the AutoCAD Civil3d? So what you do is you just come here and type import points. But before you do that, maybe you want to make sure that because the points come in meters, the drawing should also be in meter. So what you do is just go to edit, drawings, settings, like that, and make sure that the drawing units are in meters. Also, maybe you want to configure the coordinate system. So we are in this data was picked somewhere in Kenya, and the coordinate system is that 7 degrees south. So just apply like that. After that, now you want to import the points. So one way you can do that is just come here and type import points. So enter, and now there is this window that gives you the option how to import. So you just click this and files button, and then that file, I have it on the desktop. So this is the Excel file. So open. And as you can see, there is a point format to match. So for example, I have a point elevation, north, point easting, northings, and z is elevation, but we don't have the description. So we pick this one, and now in case you want to add more points, the best way is to use the point group. So this is good to enable you to separate your point. For example, you can bring more points, and then if you want to identify them, there's still an easier way of identifying the points that you have input into the AutoCAD. So you just come and click add points to a point group, and now you just create the point group. So maybe I can call them, can even give by the date. So maybe I can just write that first January 24, maybe 2024 points. Okay. And now you can see this is a sample of the points, or this is the list of the points. And you are good to go. You just stick with the default and click OK. So the points are now being inserted into AutoCAD. So we can just come and go to zoom extents, and these are the points. So maybe they look a bit congested. What you can do is just come here and change the scale. Maybe let's try a scale of 1:100. Yes, and you can now see they are better and displayed. So this is usually an issue of scale. So sometimes just try to adjust the scale. Maybe let's even try 75, like that. Now you can see there is a point that have been displayed, and for example, we want to change the appearance of these points. And what you can do is just come here to the point groups. Now we want to just go to the properties so that you can be able to change their appearance. So what we are having here is the points, elevation and description, which I think is okay. There are more. You can also have only the description, or elevation and description, or elevation and or nothings and distance. For now, let's just stick with that one. So this this X mark here is being controlled by the point style. So maybe we can change that one. Let's just try something different like that. Apply. Okay. Apply. So now you can see we have changed the appearance of the point. And notice this is only happening only on the point group. So you can bring more points and then have them displayed using a different mark or in a different format. The other thing you might want to do is for example, I might feel that I don't want all these points. Maybe my area of reference has been determined by a different edge of my survey. So maybe let's even suppose I want to have my last point determined by some point here, or the boundary of my survey, and is only just need to come here and maybe can have this one. Maybe that's some bacon. What else do you have? More points. Maybe we can just use this one here, and let's even have another point here, and just cross the polygon. So this is now the boundary of my survey, but you can see there are more points, and I'm going to show you how you can have your surface just being within this kind of boundary. So the next thing you might want to do is to have some landmarks which can be described by the kind of survey that you did. For example, I just want to have a 3D polygon. So what I wanted to show you is after you have brought up your points here, you have been important the points, you can join the points by a 3D polygon. to create what is known as a break line. So what a break line does, it defines the, for example, the structures, drains, edges of roads, and when you create the surface, they can help to better form your surface. So as you can see, I have this 3d polylines. So you can go ahead and find such areas that you want to maybe join. You can also join the structures like buildings, corners of buildings and all that. The other thing I want to show you before we make the surface is something called the description keys. So for example, you see we have trees. So let's find a tree. So there's something called the description key, and what you do, you go to the settings and then you go to the point. Then after going to the point, you can see that we have the description key here. So what you do, you just come here and you can just go to the properties. No, you go to edit keys. Then after that, now this is the key here. So for example, I want to show the tree. So what I do, I can just come here and edit this one, because I can see the tree is TR, so small r, and then I use the wild count. So the wild count means any more characters will just be used to define a tree. And then we just see what is the style used. So you just come here and you can find there is a tree. So let's see if we have another kind of a tree. So you just come here, tree in the cinders, tree evergreen. So it will depend with the kind of tree, but just make sure that it's something which it can be representative of your point. So you just do like that. So that is okay. What else do we need? Maybe I think there is a, let's see if we have something else we can use. But just most of the time you find such features, and these are usually blocks. So it's just a matter of just going to the it is just finding the location of your blocks and where you have them stored. The other thing is just to see the way the point labels have been stored. So it can just be point elevation and description, which is the same like what we have here. So we just close this one, and then for us to be able to display them here, you can just come here and go to the prospector, and then at this point you just go say apply description key. So now you can see we have all the points, and now they are displayed according to the these we have the trees now here. So we don't have to pick one tree by one tree by one tree. No, that is not a good way of working. Likewise, you also do the same for maybe if it is a street right, and so on and so forth. Now the final part here is how to create the surface. So you just come to the tool space, then go to the prospector, and then surface. So surface, you just create surface, and you just come here and give the surface a name, maybe OGL surface, like that. Okay, now that you have created a surface, it doesn't have information. So what you just want to have is the, you can just come here and use the point group. So just and the point group, and these are the points that you want to use. So apply. Okay, now we have the, let's see what we have, because what we now bring to the AutoCAD is a surface described by the points that we have that into the into AutoCAD. So what you now need to do is also to add now these 3D polylines. So we just come here, and now we can add the break lines. So and maybe we can call them rings like that. And then okay, now you want to just have them here and just like that. So we can then go back to the surface properties, and then we can change the surface the way it is appearing. So maybe we want to have the contours. Maybe this one you can just change, say for example 0.25, and then you can use the one for example, and then contour smoothing. So you can just change here, apply. And now you want to also have the display, then you want to show the contours. Is it possible to, we have the major and the minor, so they are already there. I think they should display. Yes, now you can see we have our surface and it is being displayed correctly. So what else can you do? For example, we don't want our surface going all the way and overflowing. So what we can do is we can just trim, but then we don't have to do the manual trimming. So we just use this boundary. So we just come here and go boundaries, then and so you can just give it an acronym BND for example, and then just stick with the so we now have trimmed our surface. So what this means is our surface discontinuous, but the points will still remain. So this is our surface that you have created.